I brought it back. We need to talk.
Damn right. Lots for me to explain. But not here. The Knight's got ears. We can have our talk in your head. You have a room there, right?
How do you know about that?
I'm your grandfather. What don't I know?
You know about my mind place? How is that possible?
We all have the power. Find the truth. Damn right I do. Odin already told you you're a seer. You can gaze into their heads, see the truth. See past the lies. Past this bullshit horror story. Us Andersons aren't bound by it. You can fight it. Don't be the story. Make the story.
It's true. I am a seer. I have a power. My mind place is more than I thought it was. This isn't my intuition. I'm seeing their thoughts. Is this why I know the truth about Logan? While everyone else forgot? You said you were my grandfather. If that's true, why wasn't I told about you?
You were part of our fucked up family, way before this horror story. I was a shitty fucking dad to Freya. Your mom didn't deserve that. Not one bit. Things were said and done. Not a day goes by I haven't regretted it. But that fucking father of yours didn't make things any easier. I know Freya is gone. So I need to apologize to you. I am sorry, Saga.
I can see he's sorry. Mom said she didn't want anything to do with my grandfather. And that my father died before I could remember. It all matches. Tor and Odin aren't part of my family. You said you were a shitty father to my mom. Is that why she left?
Freya never looked back. My girl was strong. Freya always thought our powers had a dangerous side. Odin and me did fuck with things that should not have been fucked with. Your mom had common sense. She raised you right. Kept you safe. I'm not surprised she didn't tell you about the Anderson power.
She was always protecting me. Whenever I told my mom about my mind place, she called it make-believe. I wish she'd been more honest with me. At least towards the end. Mom wouldn't talk about my father. You knew him?
Some doors are better left closed. Your dad was a complicated bastard. Always thinking too many steps ahead. That's not how we work. There was trouble, and then he was gone. I didn't handle it well. Freya didn't want anything to do with me after that. I can't blame her.
I never knew my dad or my mom's family. So many broken relationships in my past. I won't lose mine. With Logan. With David. I won't stop until they're safe. I have the clicker. Can I use it to save my daughter?
An app? Get your guitar roaring and your drums crashing. Blow reality's eardrums. Just the light switch isn't enough. It's Tom's story we're dealing with, so he's gotta be the one to rewrite it. After that's done, he can flick that switch to bring the whole thing home, baby.
I can't use the clicker without Wake. Tom. Meaning Wake. He needs to rewrite the story first. I can't stop the horror story without him. Overlaps require pieces of art to enter. Is that because of the Dark Place's focus on art? That's it. Ugh. Wake needs to be the one to rewrite the ending. And I'll need to keep an eye on him. The story doesn't affect me like it does other people. Because of who I am. Because of my family. The way Tor behaved? I'm surprised my mom hung around for as long as she did. But he is genuinely sorry. Tor and Odin can actually speak with me in my mind place, thanks to their own powers. Doesn't look right. Tor and Odin are my relatives. The evidence fits with what I know is true. It's a lot to process. Wake wrote Logan into the story. He had no right to use her like this. There is still time to make him fix it. I won't give him a choice. Tor is here, in the overlap. Gotta find him and get the fuck out. Thanks for telling me this, Tor. I need to go find Wake to stop this.
The old gods of Asgard will be ready to help. Me and my bro will bring the rock when you need it. Remember, your daughter is alive. Just kept from you by this bullshit horror story.
I needed to hear that. Thanks, Grandpa.
Don't worry about me, kiddo. I'll drag my sorry ass over to Odin. A few shots at the finest will fix us both up. See you soon, Saga.
The FBC is holding Wake at the sheriff's station. I need to make Agent Estevez understand. They have Wake and I have the clicker. We have to work together to stop this. Kate. Damn it. Where are you, Casey? He better be okay. Focus, Saga. Get to the station. To Wake. Get the clicker to Wake, and make him fix his attempt to play God. That's the plan. But the FBC have him.
Ilmo was nervous. His palms were clammy. He lowered his phone. Mulligan isn't picking up. Yako shook his head, pointed at his own phone. Same with Thornton. Ilmo didn't like it. No one was answering the phone at the workshop in Watery either. Something was up. It had to be the writer. Had to be. night was bingo night at the Valhalla nursing home. Each time Rose drew a ball from the cage and called out its number, some of the residents shouted bingo, no matter what was on their cards. Some of them sat mute, their cards full, never calling out. Some of them would try to steal the ball from her. Some of them would chastise the others for acting out. It was like herding a clowder of cats. Rose didn't mind. She liked cats. She knew she was where she was supposed to be, with her little Vikings, waiting for the hero to come. Tonight, the residents were restless, more so than usual. Ati was wearing Blum's coveralls again. Tor stood by the phone. Too late. Rose saw the hammer in his hand. The garden lights started to flicker, the darkness and rain pressing against the windows. The time drew nigh.
People were calling in about Winnie Davis going missing, but it sounds Alan Walker fellow you're talking about. Terry, you were there last Sunday.
Another one of those cult boxes.
Sorry.
all of them. There we go.
Thank you.
81st annual Deer Fest was just around the corner. Everyone in Bright Falls was bustling. There were banners to be hung, pies baked, deer masks sold. Bright Falls had made the top 100 American small town lists for its modest, rustic charm. The town expected a lot of tourists this year, but a shadow hung over the Deer Fest preparations. The forecast promised rain. Fearful whispers promised more murders. The police were on high alert. Sheriff Breaker had deputies patrolling the streets at night. Bright Falls was no stranger to odd happenings, but to cancel Deer Fest? Out of the question. The townsfolk were anxious, their anticipation mixed with fear. People had restless dreams. The lights seemed dimmer. Floodwater pressed in on the town, and the shadows poured in with it.
Another locked box.
broken door!
More of those rhymes. Doesn't look right. That's not right. Oh. Nah. No. Keep trying. Sure. Lots of charms lying around here. Another rhyme. Okay.
A charm,
my bracelet. there's another cult stash.
Okay.
those people just burst in here and expect others to clean up after them. So what do you think that whole thing at the lodge was about?
I don't think. It's better not to get mixed up with that lodge.
Oh, so you do know something after all. You know, I bet that biker gang from the next town over had... Those people just burst in here and expect others to clean up after them.
Hello?
It won't open.
Oh, hello there.
They think they're so mysterious, they're ridiculous masks. Children in costumes. another one of those cult boxes.
He wouldn't just wander off and not tell us. Especially after all the weirdness of the law.
Another cult stash?
The fishes are biting again. Yeah, they didn't like all that hubbub earlier.